We are going back in time to the year 29 AD. You are in Galilee. Imagine the landscape, the sandy ground, the trees and shrubs. Feel the warm sun shining on your face. Imagine the Sea of Galilee in the distance. Feel the breeze. Breathe the air. Imagine a town in Galilee. Notice the clay houses of the town, the dusty roads. See the people in the town, people in the market, people tending to animals, children playing, people working in shops and around their homes. Notice the colors. Listen to the sounds. Imagine a home in this town. Imagine that it is your home. Imagine what it looks like. What do you see around your home? What things need to be tended to? What needs to be done? Tend to the work around your home. Think about what you are doing. What are you thinking about as you work? Spend some time tending to your task. Friends are passing by your home. You can see them walking on the road. You call out a greeting. Where are you going? They tell you that Jesus has come home. They are on their way to see him. Jesus, he was a childhood friend. You both grew up in this town. Remember times you spent with your friend Jesus. Remember playing with him as a child. Remember how much fun you would have together at the festivals. Remember a visit he made to your house with his mother, Mary, during a time of crisis. Remember visiting his family's carpenter shop. Jesus was just an apprentice. You look around your house and notice the bench that you had purchased that day. Jesus left the town some time ago. You really don't know why, but it seemed to have had something to do with that John the Baptist person who had been preaching around here. Jesus had gone to hear him preach one day and then had disappeared. You have heard the rumors around town. Rumors that Jesus himself was now preaching and that he had attracted a number of followers. Some said that he healed people, even lepers and people with demons. And now it seems Jesus has come home. Your friends are standing on the road. They ask if you would like to go with them to see Jesus. Yes, you would like to go. You are walking to Jesus' house. Feel the road beneath your feet. Feel the pace of your footsteps as you travel down the road. What are you thinking? What are you expecting? You are approaching the house. You see that there is a crowd gathered around the doorway. Townspeople mostly, but also some of the temple priests. Others are also arriving. You notice some men coming towards the house, carrying someone on a mat. The crowd is noisy. People are clamoring around the door, trying to see Jesus. You find yourself in the midst of the crowd and struggle to get to a place where you can see and hear what is happening. You catch a glimpse of Jesus inside the house as he speaks to the people in the crowd. He is greeting people, answering questions, addressing inquiries about what he has been doing. You listen closely, trying to hear what he is saying. Jesus is distracted by dirt falling on his face. He looks up. You see that someone is tearing a hole in the roof. You watch as the hole gets bigger, and you recognize the faces of the men who were carrying the man on the mat. They continue tearing through the roof. Now they are using rope to try to lower something into the room. It is the man on his mat, obviously crippled and unable to do much for himself. They are lowering him slowly into the room and struggle to keep him from toppling from his bed. You look to Jesus for reaction. The man comes to rest at the feet of Jesus. Jesus looks up at the faces of the men on the roof. He looks at the crippled man lying on his mat. You hear him say to the man, "Your sins are forgiven." The crowd begins murmuring around you. You hear a priest behind you mutter, "Who does he think he is? Only God can forgive sins." The crowd murmurs. Jesus looks up at the crowd, resting his eyes for a moment past you and into the eyes of the priest. He says, "Why do you think such things? Is it not easier to tell a paralyzed man that his sins are forgiven than to tell him to get up and walk? I will show you that the Son of Man has the authority to forgive sin." Jesus bends down to the crippled man. He speaks to him, and you hear him say to the man, "Get up, pick up your mat, and go home." It is quiet. The man is looking at Jesus. The crowd erupts in conversation. Jesus is coming outside, walking among people. People are talking. Some draw close to Jesus, praising God. Others stand aside in hushed conversation. Jesus continues to walk through the crowd, pausing to touch or speak to people. He is close to where you are. He moves in front of you and stops. You look at him. He looks at you. He is saying something to you. What is he saying? Listen to the words. Respond to them. Spend a moment with Jesus. When you and he have finished, you turn and begin walking home. Time passes. You are now on your way to Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover. It has been a long journey, and you find yourself standing on a street in Jerusalem. Look around. It is a warm, dry day. The crowds are noisy and bustling, people rushing here and there. You feel the heat, the rush of the crowd, the dirt under your feet, the dust as it rises and sticks to your moist skin. You are walking towards the marketplace to get bread for the evening meal. As you approach the market, you hear the sounds of animals, chicken, sheep. You can smell the odors of the animals mingled with the sweet smell of fruit and the fresh baked bread. The crowds are heavy as you draw closer to the market. A man runs into you as he hurries down the street. You turn to watch as he rushes past. A crowd of people is pushing past you. Others are pushing to the side of the road. They are clearing the way for something coming down the road. You look into the road and see a man. No, there are two and then three men struggling to walk. Their heads are hung and their bodies strain under the burden which each bears. A cross. A cross. You realize that these men are on their way to be executed. You You hear voices in the crowd shouting for crucifixion. You wonder what crime they have committed. Two of the men pass, and the third is passing in front of you. He is bent and struggles to stay on his feet. Just as he comes even with you, he stumbles and falls. He is lying in the road. After a few moments, he tries to stand again under the weight of the cross, but he is falling again. He turns his head toward the crowd. He is looking up at you. You draw a breath of recognition. It is someone you know. It is Jesus. A guard is pushing past you and grabs the man standing next to you. The man is strong and rugged. He is ordered to carry the prisoner's cross. The man walks over to Jesus. He helps him to his feet. He then bends over and lifts the cross to his shoulder. He struggles for a moment as he tries to balance the weight of the heavy wood. When it is secure, he begins walking down the road. Jesus and the guards follow behind. You are watching them go. The crowd is pushing you forward, following. You allow yourself to follow with them. You are walking to the outskirts of the city. The crowd is pushing around you. Occasionally, you catch a glimpse of Jesus and the guard and the man carrying the cross. You see the city gates ahead of you and continue towards them. You are outside of the city now. The crowds have loosened up in the open space. You see the hill ahead, Golgotha, it is called, where the executions take place. The other two prisoners are already there and their crosses erected. You are following the crowds to that hill. You see Jesus ahead of you, just beginning to walk up the hill. The man with the cross is ahead of him. You approach the hill and stop. You are watching. The cross is now lying at the top of the hill. Jesus is pushed to the ground. His arms are stretched out, and you see hammers. The hammers are being raised over Jesus' hands and suddenly come down with a thud. You see Jesus flinch ever so slightly. The hammers continue to pound. You can hear them over the murmur of the crowd. The cross is being lifted and secured as you watch. You see the three crosses as they stand against the darkening sky. You hear the sound of people weeping to one side as you watch. You see the guards gathered at the foot of Jesus' cross. They are crouching, discussing something. You watch. You remember the last time you saw him, when the invalid got up and walked. You remember him coming over, talking with you that day. You remember what he said. You watch the sky darkening in the distance. You see that the crowd is dispersing. You watch and see that Jesus is dying on the cross.